Welcome to Tomoe Workout. This is one of my full body circuit workout I like to do. When I start my home gym workout, I like to turn up. So I put on some dope hip hop music or whatever that's gonna pump me up. Usually I like to do this after I come back from a long day of work. And we're gonna start off by push-ups. So, as you can see in this clip, I like to spread my legs hip distance. This way I have a four stance support rather than having my legs closed, which will be considered three stance support. And I probably do about 8 to 10 reps. Since because it is a circuit workout, I take minimal breaks. So I like to shrug my shoulder, rotate my neck, and then I go back into it again. Because I had a long day at work, physically, you know, my body should be warmed up, but also to prevent injuries, I like to diagnose how my body is. And as we go, we will get into the next set, which, when you do your push-ups, what I recommend is do it with control. You know, that's very important, because in that way, you're actually using the muscle group for the actual workout. So let's go back in again for the third set. And don't forget to breathe in and out. Very important each rep, breathe in and out. Don't hold your breath, because then you're just going to suffocate yourself. Take another rest, diagnose yourself. I like to check my shoulders and my neck. And then from here, we're gonna grab a yoga block. And if you don't have a yoga block, just use a book or any kind of physical object. And we're gonna start working our lower abs and abs, or upper and mid ab. So, with this particular workout, I don't have a repetition per se. I do it for maybe 30 seconds, maybe 60 seconds, depending on your current condition. And I just create different patterns. So by creating different patterns, you're making your body guess what you're gonna do. For example, like P90X, right? It's a 90 days intense workout where every day you're doing something different. That is because once the muscles build those memories of a routine, it knows what to expect, which prevents from the progress that you want. So that's why I like to do this particular workout for my abs, because it's fun. I get to use my full body and I get to get creative a little bit. And once I can't catch my breath anymore, I will take a pause, micro breaks, you can call it, and then on to the next, which is a body weight squat. So when you do a body weight squat, make sure that you're putting your weight on your heel. So as you squat down, you want to almost think of like you're sitting on a chair. Right, so if you're squatting correctly, your toes, you can lift your toes up. That means that, you know, your central gravity is pretty good. And if you can't get to that part, it's okay. Little by little, you will achieve that goal. And pause again, shake your legs off, drink some water. Again, this is a 20 minutes or so body circuit workout, and I like to crank it out when I have to wake up next day pretty early, but this is how I like to decompress after a good day at work. Then we'll go back to the next set, which is gonna be a little different. So when you do a bodyweight squat, this time you're gonna lower yourself slowly with control, and then you're gonna shoot back up. So lower slowly, and then shoot back up. And I have my arms out. This is something I just do for fun because in yoga, hot yoga, there is a certain pose where we have our arms out for balance. And it's nice to practice trusting to put your weight on your heels, because by having your arms out, you can kind of counteract that weight. But when you do so, make sure you're not shrugging your shoulders and getting tense. So we're gonna shake it out again. You know, keep that heart pumping. And then we'll go to the next set. So this set is an opposite of the second set. We're gonna go down, but go back up slowly, again with control. Go down, and go back up slowly. So inhale when you go down, and exhale as you rise back up. Again, breathing is key in anything you do. We tend to hold our breath, and then we go, you know, that's because we've been holding our breath. And this is something I practice on daily routine, because we get so focused into doing something that we forget to breathe consciously. And it is very important in any aspect of life, I believe, that you are aware that you're breathing. You know, we breathe unconsciously, but to breathe consciously, it does take practice. But the result you can get over time is actually pretty phenomenal. So with this one, I probably do maybe 5 or 8 reps and 3 sets. I always stick with 3 sets. And with the circuit workout, I like to also make it fun. Each set can be with different repetition. Like you can go 5, 7, 5, 8, 9, 10, or you can go 8, 5, 10, you know, change it up a little bit, and then shake it off again, get some water, you know, get in the zone, know your intention of working out. You know, we have to take care of our body, because it is so easy to get stuck in a routine that our body will get stiff over time, and that is really not that healthy for the future of your own health. So now what we're gonna do is what's called a pistol squat, or one-legged squat. And for this one in particular, my central gravity is not so well currently, so I like to use my couch as a support system. Then over time, I would try to not use my couch, and if I do lose my balance, I would just touch the ground and readjust. And don't forget to breathe in and out again. And we'll do the same on the other leg. Pump yourself up. You know, it's grind mode. It's no time to pretend. This is for your tomorrow self. You know, do something today where you will thank yourself tomorrow. You may be sore the next day, but that's a good kind of pain. And don't forget to breathe in and out. Now, holding your breath is the worst thing you can possibly do. And always use the right form. What I realize is that I'd rather do less repetition and have right form than do more repetition and have a terrible form. Because if you have a terrible form, most likely you will injure yourself. And that's kind of inevitable when you do have the wrong form. And we want to avoid that. Alright, so on to the next, guys. Like, we got this. 10 minutes in. And this is a little fun ab workout I like to do. I like to bring my left knee to my right elbow, vice versa, right knee to my left elbow. I'm sorry, right knee to my left elbow, left knee to right elbow. And I try to do it fast, but again, I don't have the lungs for it. You know, something I've been working on by running, but little by little, small progress leads to big success. And with this one in particular, again, I don't have any repetition count per se. I just do it till I kind of burn out. And when it comes to workout, what I realize is that it's all about having fun. Having fun, but it's hard. Having fun, but it's difficult, right? If you have a goal in mind, it won't be per se easy, but if it's fun because you know each day you're getting to that goal, that's what makes a dream come true. Right? If you don't set a goal, your dream is not, it's just a dream. So the next workout that I like to do is called floor crawling. I put my heels against the wall. This one I'm doing it on the couch. And then I crawl as far as I can and then crawl back. When I crawl back, I have my knees slightly bent because my hamstrings aren't as flexible yet. So, and to prevent hyperextension, I like to bend my knees. So this is also a different kind of planking. It's fun. Planking can get a little boring because you're holding a certain position for a certain amount of duration. With this, you're crawling as far as you can and then crawling back. So you get to kind of see the movements more. And yeah, this is a great full body execution in a sense if you want to feel a good burn. With this one, I don't have any repetition. I do it as many as I can. I think around like 5 or 6, I start sweating. So probably I went and did it 8 or so. Push myself for the last 2 reps. So now, take a little break. You're in the zone right now. Get some water. And then we'll go on to the next one. So this is a side lunge I like to do. So when I do the side lunge, right now I'm doing my right. I try to focus pushing myself up with only my right leg. The left leg is a support, right? And again, do it with control. It's not about how fast you can do it. Alright, it's about how well you can do it. Right? If you can do 5 correct form, that's better than doing 8 incorrect form. So after, whatever you do though, do the same amount of repetition on the other leg. Very important, because you do not want to favor one muscle group to another. And that applies to, again, all workouts. And don't forget to breathe. And take a break. I like to shake my leg off, maybe stretch it out a little bit. And for this one, I am taking a little bit longer break because that planking, the floor crawling, that kind of take out of breath out of me. And it's okay. You know, some people can crush it through. In my case, I like to take time. And this one is a little fun squat and kick I like to do, just to keep my leg warm. Hella drama, my life story. Faith of a mustard seed, I kept growing. I knew that this life was meant for me. Niggas change up more than and every time I do the kick, I either kick it in front of me or across. switch it up.
Nigga, I don't act, but I act up. Brown paper bag like the lunch packed up. Back up. Nigga, I'ma need like 10 feet or get stomped out with 10 feet. I'ma always lose my temper. You cannot count to 10 me. If I lose one, I bounce back like 2-3, deal with 4-5. Damn. Seen courtrooms and court size. Ain't too many, seen both sides. Nigga, fuck what you know.
So this one is one of my favorite lunges. I like to call it the cross lunge, because not only I'm working my thighs, I get to also stretch my hip flexors. And I think this applies to everybody, that if you sit for longer duration and also stand long duration, your hip flexor will eventually get stiff. And this is one of the work I like to do to loosen it up, because I work in the kitchen, so I'm on my feet all the time. And when I am working on my YouTube, my blogging, I am sitting on a desk for 4 to 5 hours. So hip flexor is very important to stretch. We tend to miss the basics of our body that is the most needed part in working out or stretching out. Now we're already 16 minutes into our workout. You got this. We're gonna keep going. Get that blood pumping. Motivate yourself. So for this one, I'm gonna set my time to 60 seconds of planking. And when it comes to planking, set your elbows shoulder width apart. I like my legs hip distance apart. Make sure your ab is engaged and you're breathing. It's interesting, when we do difficult stuff, time seems to be longer. But that's all in your head. But if you're focusing on the muscle group or focusing on what you're doing, time will fly by without you noticing. So I remind myself, what is my intention, right? My intention is to keep a healthy body so I can do what I like, whether if that's rock climbing, jogging, walking for hours. And also, it's good to be physically capable, because you never know what life will throw at you. And if you want to try it, it's nice to not worry about the physical limits. So once the 60 seconds of the planking is done, drink some water, catch your breath. Planking always gets me. It always does. And don't forget to breathe in and out, because planking is one of my weaknesses when it comes to holding my breath. So let's go for the second set. Same form, 60 seconds again. Keep your abs engaged. I like to picture that I'm like a sphinx when I do my planks, because I think that's super cool. And sometimes I like to swing side to side, forward and backwards, because second steps of planking is always difficult. Nice, you did it. Take a breather. drink some water, get your heart rate down a little bit. And it's already been 20 minutes. We just got a little bit more. And sometimes when I do planking, I like to meditate for like 30 seconds to a minute. Just bring myself centered. Get back in an equanimity state. And then when I'm ready, I'm ready to pump it out again. So get those blocks. And these blocks are awesome. Like, I recommend to anybody, rather than getting weights, because you can do a lot with it. Especially for like ab workouts and also yoga too. So what I'm doing here is restacking the blocks, or not restacking the blocks, right? Again, it's having fun and being creative with your workout. It's a little rough. This is actually my first time doing this way while I was filming. And then when I stack the blocks, I try to do it with control as well. And it burns. It's a really good workout. I am a fan of it. And you guys got it, you know, take a break, then reset, and go for it again. Come swing the thing right by me. Got a joint if you wanna get stoned. Got choppers if they wanna try me. Pro athlete, I'm not no wannabe. Waitress asked how many bottles, I said 23. The concept of the home gym works for me because the time that I have to invest in commuting to a gym and commuting back to the gym, it takes an amount of time that I don't really want to take throughout the day. So by having the intention of, okay, I'm going to do 20 minutes full body circuit workout, it's better than myself going to a gym, which may take 15, 20 minutes, and then maybe work out for an hour or two, you know, because if there's people around me, I'm gonna socialize, I'm gonna see what kind of workouts they're doing. So this time, we're gonna spread the blocks about a little wider than hip distance, and this time I have my legs like chopstick. And I'm going through each block slowly than the first time. This is to work on my control, so that way I am consciously aware that I am keeping my abs engaged as I'm doing it. This may be a little harder. I try not to have my feet touch the ground. I try to keep it elevated at all times. But, you know, if your abs aren't there yet, or your strength is not there yet, it's okay to put the feet on the ground, you know? Again, you don't want to overdo yourself. Yeah, I know only want to get the job done. I don't know a nigga that could cover for me. Yeah. And even with this, I like to change my pattern too. She don't love me like she say she love me. Believe me, believe me, believe me. I'm a nigga boy that love me in the street. Stand back up and shake it off. You know, thank yourself for making the time to invest in yourself. This is part of self-care. Thank you for being at Tomo Workout.